Roque was invited by the squad committee. And Attorney Harry Roque sent a letter dated August 13, 2024, addressed to the Honorable Chairman Robert Ace Barbers. Are you the lead chairman? Informing Chair Barbers that he will not be able to participate in said meeting due to a conflict with a previously scheduled court hearing before the Regional Trial Court of Manila on 16 August 2024, the same date of our Quad Committee hearing. I have here a copy of that particular letter. Mr. Chair, we have also in receipt here a copy of certification from Attorney Jennifer H. De La Cruz Buendia, Clerk of Court and Ex Officio Sheriff of Manila, RTC Manila, stating that Attorney Harry Roque has no hearing on August 16 and did not appear in the courts of Manila on said date. Mr. Chair, I hate to say it, but clearly, Attorney Harry Roque, our former secretary and my former professor, law professor, lied to this committee. And that amounts actually to disrespect on the members of the committee, which is contemptible under Section 11E of the Rules of the House of Representatives on inquiries in aid of legislation. I therefore move, Mr. Chair, that Attorney Harry Roque be cited for contempt for disrespecting the members of this committee when he lied to evade in order to evade attending the hearing of this committee where he was invited. So move, Mr. Chair.
I did not quite hear what you said, Congressman Salo. Can you please repeat? Are you moving for the committee to cite Mr. Attorney Harry Roque in contempt?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Pursuant to Section 11E of the Rules of the House of Representatives in aid of legislation.
Mr. Chair.
One-minute suspension. Parliamentary status is that there was a motion by Congressman Ron Salo to cite our resource person, Attorney Harry Roque, in contempt for lying before this committee when he was invited in August 16 when the Quadcom had its first public hearing. And according to that letter, he stated that he cannot attend for the reason that he has a hearing in an RTC in the city of Manila. Congressman Ron Salo read the certification issued by the Clerk of Court of the RTC Manila, which states that the hearing where Attorney Harry Roque is a counsel was scheduled in August 15 and not August 16. And in August 16, there was a certification from the same Clerk of Court saying that Harry Roque has no hearing in any of the RTC of the city of Manila. That is the parliamentary status, Your Honors, and there is a pending motion by Congressman Ron Salo to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt for lying before this committee when he submitted an excuse to his being absent in our hearing last August 16. Now, pursuant to our rules, Section 11 of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation, it says that the committee may punish any person for contempt by a vote of two-thirds of the members present, there being a quorum. The following shall be the grounds for citing any person in contempt. In this case, as stated by Congressman Salo, the reason for the contemptible act committed by our resource person is in paragraph E, which reads, acting in a disrespectful manner towards any member of the committee or any misbehavior in the presence of the committee. So, may I solicit comments from our members before we rule on this motion? In the spirit of fairness, because the committee has been citing our resource persons who have violated this rule in contempt and detaining them before detaining them in the premises of the House of Representatives. Would there be any comment from our members?
Mr. Chair, before we vote,
Chairman Labonte,
before we vote of the contempt, we would like to hear first the explanation of the reason behind his absence to this committee last year.
Thank you, Your Honor. I was hoping to be given an opportunity to be heard. It was an honest mistake, Your Honor. I have also been a member of this chamber. We don't hold hearings on Fridays. So when I saw the notice of hearing, I assumed that just like the first and the second hearing where I attended, that it would be on a Thursday. And that is true that I had a hearing both in the morning and in the afternoon. And that is why I sent that letter. By the time I realized that it was a Friday and there was in fact a hearing, it was also close already to lunchtime and the hearing was in Pampanga. So I apologize for the honest mistake, but the truth of the matter is I have been here on Thursdays, so two hearings already, and I just assumed that just like in the past, where we don't hold hearings on a Friday, that the hearing would be on a Thursday, as in fact, today is also a Thursday. So it was an instance of, okay, there's a hearing, it's on Thursday again, and I have a hearing on Thursday, that's why I sent the letter right away, not even realizing that 16 is a Friday. That was an honest mistake. Had I had any intentions not to appear, I would not have appeared today as well. But in the first two instances, and those were the two instances where I was invited, I in fact appeared. I have no wish to disrespect the very same body of which I was a part of, which I consider at some point in time as my happy place, in fact, the House of Representatives. Thank you, Your Honors.
Any other member who wish to make a comment?
Mr. Chairman, can we have
Congressman
a copy,
Fernandez?
Can we have a copy of that certification that was issued by the Regional Trial Court? Because I haven't seen the copy yet. And that's the reason why medyo kanina I was a bit shocked about it. So
here. So while Congressman Fernandez is still reading the certification,
Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask Secretary Roque, what is the reason for your apology?
Well, it was really an honest mistake, Your Honor.
So you're apologizing not for your absence, but for an honest mistake?
It was an honest mistake, Your Honor, because I've been here every Thursday. And as a former member of this chamber, as a former employee of this chamber, I know that in the regular course of business, we don't really have hearings on Fridays. In fact, even if you call the trunk line of the House of Representatives on a Friday, no one will answer. That has always been the policy, no? So when I saw the notice of hearing, I really thought it was also on a Thursday, like the first two hearings where I attended. That is why I apologize for the honest mistake.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Akop, and then Congressman Paduano, and then Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Akop, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Attorney Roque, nag-assume po kayo na mali, di po ba?
Nagkamali po.
Kaya nga, yung assumption nyo mali.
Opo, mali nga po yun.
And therefore, pag nag-assume ka ng mali, you should be ready for the consequences. Hindi ba dapat ganun?
Yes po, but there was no intent to disrespect this chamber.
I'm not asking whether you have the intent. Ang tinatanong ko lang po doon is, kung nag-assume po kayo ng mali, hindi po ba dapat tanggapin ninyo yung consequences?
I will, of course, accept the consequences, the decision of this body, but since I was given an opportunity to be heard, I thought that there should be allowance for honest mistakes.
Kasi, pagpasensya mo na ako. Kasi ako, I know that you have been practicing as a lawyer for a long time. Di po ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
And as a practicing lawyer, lahat po ng schedule ninyo nakalagay. For example, for the week, kung ano ang hearing mo for the week, ano yung appointment mo, nakalagay po. Di po ba?
Totoo po yun. Kaya nga po, dun sa certificate, talagang may hearing po ako nung Thursday. And mali nga lang po yung assumption ko na yung sumunod na hearing ay hindi na pala Thursday dahil so, puro Thursday po tayo.
Ang ibig nyo pong sabihin, wala sa schedule ninyo yung dapat umattend kayo ng hearing sa Friday, nung Friday?
Yun nga po, nailagay ko po siya ng Thursday kasi every Thursday po yung hearing natin.
Then, as it is, kayo po lahat ang may kasalanan. Wala.
Opo, pero wala naman.
Participation ng iba.
Opo, pero wala naman pong intention to disrespect the chamber.
Hindi ko po kine-question yung intention nyo. Ang kine-question ko lang, as a practicing lawyer, ang alam ko, yung mga lawyers, meron silang sinusulatan lahat ng kanilang mga schedule. In your case, kung nakalagay yung schedule na yun, dun sa yung event na yun, sa yung book of schedules, dapat alam ninyo.
Sa totoo nga lang po, dahil akala ko Thursday, nakita ko na ng morning afternoon ng hearing ko, sumulat na ako kaagad to inform the committee as soon as possible dahil ang buong akala ko po talaga Thursday.
Attorney Roque, marami na pong namatay dahil sa maling akala. Kindly bear that in mind. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Acop. Congressman Paduano, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, tama po yung sinabi ni Chairman Acop na that's your fault and you should face the consequences, di ba? Now, eto lang po. Kaya ako, of course, the intent, hindi pwede nating pag-usapan dito yung intent. Kasi, the question is, well, in fact, you're calling the chairman of this committee. Well, in fact, you text me with regards to your request for your wife to be excused in today's hearing. Now, as you mentioned, nalaman mo na after lunch, nag-hearing sa Pampanga, di ba? At the very least, man lang, sana you texted me, you call me, or you call the chairman na hindi po ako makarating dyan kasi nagkamali ako. But you never do it. Kaya yung question of intent, sabi ko nga, hindi pwede magiging basis for that possible contempt, no? Na minove ni Congressman Ronzalo. Kaya ako, ang ano ko lang dito is supposedly, at the very least, again, you have texted or called us. If not me, you called Chairman Abante, well, in fact, on that request, you called Chairman Barbers, but you never do it. So, ako, Mr. Chairman, I join the motion of the first motion of Congressman Salo. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Paduano.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Fernandez. Congressman Abante.
Mr. Chair, the fact that Secretary Roque appeared with us today and apologized to the committee. At sinabi po ni Congressman Acop kung nagkamali siya, sinabi naman po nagkamali siya, I'd like to ask that we hold in abeyance the motion until such time that all of us would jointly join the motion of Congressman Salo. Also, I'd like to open this debate to any member of the committee to say something about this, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Chair. Congressman Abante. Congressman Joel Chua, you're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, gusto ko lang pong tanongin si Attorney Harry Roque. Nung sabi po ninyo kanina, it was just an honest mistake, tama po ba? Dahil sabi po ninyo, ang akala ninyo is Thursday. So nung Thursday po ba, nagpadala kayo agad ng notice sa amin? Or at the very least, nag-inform po kayo agad?
Tuesday po, pinadala ko po. Dahil nakita ko conflict nga po sa calendar.
Tuesday
po.
So na-realize lang ninyo na Friday pala nung...
Friday na po at nabalitaan ko na nagko-quad hearing po sa Pampanga.
Pero yung quad hearing, parang umaga pa lang po yata. May quad hearing na eh. Tama po ba?
Correct po. I took the day off because I was also not feeling well last Friday.
So, noong Friday po, masamang pakiramdam ninyo?
Yes po. Opo.
So, ano pong ginawa ninyo nung Friday, nung na-realize ninyo? Wala po ba? Dati po, sabi po ninyo kanina, na iba po sa amin, kasabay pa po ninyo. Wala po ba kayong kahit isa man lamang po na tinext o tinawagan?
Well, kasi masama din po talaga ang aking pakiramdam. And in fact, I have a medical certificate today where the doctor recommended that I should be confined in a hospital. Pero I did not consider that because I said, I have to appear now because I missed the last hearing. But I have the medical certificate if your honors would wish to see it. But my attendance here reaffirms my commitment to explain and answer all your queries because I have nothing to hide.
Pero nung Friday po ba, hindi po kayo na-confine sa hospital?
Hindi po. Nagpahinga lang po talaga ako because I had very strange feelings for the first time. It was an electric feeling in the neck. And I thought that by just resting, it will go away.
Okay. So nung nalaman po ninyo na nag-hearing na po yung Quadcom, wala rin po kayong na-text o wala rin po kayong ginawa nung araw na yon?
Oh, nagpahinga lang po ako nung araw na yon.
Okay. Thank you po.
Mr. Chair. Thank you, Congressman Chua. Congressman Fernandez and then Congressman Alaganza.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I tend to believe the statement of the former Secretary Roque, but when I was reading the certification or the letter addressed to us, I noticed that there was no branch number ng Regional Trial Court of Manila. Secretary, is this something that is intentional or you're trying to mislead us in order for us not to find out?
Hindi po. The name of the case is People versus Madriaga and I appear as a private prosecutor. It is a case po for kidnapping with the ransom.
That was on August 15, 2024.
Yun nga po eh, Thursday. So yun nga po yung naisip ko na dahil Thursday po tayo as I said, wala pong...
And also, hindi nailagay yung branch number ng
RTC.
Po.
Pero the certificate would, I think, attest that I was in the RTC.
Sa letter mo, wala yung branch number.
Oh, hindi ko po nailagay na yan.
Yun ang medyo... you should have written the branch number of the RTC. But nevertheless, with your saying his apology, but you should have sent a letter or communication to all of us. We're just a phone away, and we will understand. But personally, I will leave it to the body to decide on the motion of Congressman Ron Salon. Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman
Mr.
Fernandez.
Chair, can you list me to be recognized after... Okay.
Congressman Arrogancia and then Congressman Paul Daza.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to ask the good secretary, as per your letter, at inamin niyo po kanina na honest mistake ang supposed to be Thursday na akala mong hearing natin dito po sa Kongreso. At lagi niyo na pong inuulit-ulit na you were once part of the Congress and Congress is part of the, like a second home to you before. Basically, wala nagka-question sa'yo dun sa sinasabi niyong this is part of your home. Or you were once part of the Congress, and we know that. Ang Quadcom po, Mr. Secretary, ay hindi lang po si invitation nyo siguro nakita. Definitely po, alam naman po siguro ninyo na meron pong hearing ng Friday kasi makikita nyo rin po naman po ito sa news sa television, Mr. Secretary. Considering, nakalimutan nyo po ng Thursday na meron po tayong hearing, halimbawa, nagkamali kayo, honest mistake, hindi po ba dapat inalam ninyo kung ano ang naging come out o come up doon sa hearing ng Thursday kung sakali halimbawa ang akala ninyo na merong hearing ng Thursday? Dapat po inalam ninyo na what happened sa hearing. Another thing, supposed to be Friday ang ating hearing, hindi nyo po ba inalam na yung Friday po, anong nangyari nung Thursday? And then nung Friday po, chinek nyo po ang calendar ninyo. Paano nyo po ba na-receive ang invitation, Mr. Secretary?
Sa email po. Sa email ko, nare-receive yan. And I receive voluminous email po talaga, no?
Yeah. Mr. Secretary, sa talino nyo po, para pong katakataka na magkamali kayo, simpleng schedule po ng araw ng hearing na napakahusay nyo pong abogado.
Well, nangyayari po talaga yon na Your Honor, no? Dahil lang nakita ko na committee on public order, so sabi ko, may hearing na naman. So, may hearing na naman this Thursday. So, ang ginagawa ko nga po ngayon, rinireserve ko na yung mga Thursdays ko, and I was going to manifest, in fact, that on next Thursday, I have an international arbitration, and there I will submit the correct form already. Pero, tinitignan ko na po talaga ang aking schedule dahil alam ko naman po matagal itong mga hearing neto. So, kumbaga po, sa korte, we also set it ahead of time. So, bina-block off ko po, tine-check ko na ako ano yung mga Thursdays na meron pong appointments.
Another thing po, sabi niyo po kanina, nung nagtatanong po si Honorable Chua sa inyo na you have already a ready medical certificate from your doctor na nagpapatunay na kayo ay hindi fit ang inyong pangangatawan. Para po na pang napaka-ironic na may ready na po kayo agad na medical certificate sa pag-attend yun ng hearing, na kung halimbawa na hindi kayo talaga okay at ina-attest ng inyong doktor, hindi kayo dapat nakarating, which is sinasabi nyo na dahil gusto nyo makaipaliwanag ang sa inyo, maging totoo sa committee na to, umattend pa rin kay despite may advice po ng inyong doktor. Para sa akin po, parang pinaghandaan nyo na po na kung sakaling kayo ay magka-problema dito sa hearing na to, may ready kayong medical certificate na ipapakita sa committee na kung sakali ay kayo excuse halimbawa sa ganitong klaseng pag-uusap ng contempt, Mr. Secretary.
Your Honor, hindi naman po ganun. Kung hindi, nag-persist po yung aking kondisyon. And I don't feel I'm on tip-top shape now. So, kaya po ako nagkonsulta talaga sa doktor din. And the advice of the doctor is, hindi na kita papauwiin because in the first place, napakabilis na iyong heartbeat and you already have a heart stent, no? Baka ka mag-collapse dyan sa house as you appear. But I explained that my wife already, who is also invited, cannot attend, so I have to go. And what I'm doing is I'm just managing. She gave me Valium para hindi daw ako ma-aggravate. But she did stress na baka ma'am niya, tumumba ka na lang dyan sa hearing na yan. But I think it's very important that I appear today dahil I have already asked members of the committee to excuse my wife. And the least I can do is to appear despite the medical advice not to do so and to be confined.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, being part of this committee, for me, my personal observation regarding the honest mistake of the good secretary is really unbelievable. Considering na kung halimbawa na nakita niya na nagkamali siya during the Thursday na ina-assume niya na meron tayong hearing, dapat nakita na niya sa news yung hearing natin supposed to be na Thursday. Where in fact, wala naman talagang hearing. Dapat nagtaka na siya na nagtanong siya at na-check niya ang kanyang calendar na ito pala yung Friday, Mr. Secretary. Parang sa akin po, napaka mababaw masyado yung pong kanyang dahilan, Mr. Chairman. Salamat po.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Arrogancia. Next is Congressman Paul Daza. You're recognized.
Good afternoon to the four chairs, the committee, my colleagues in these various committees. Good afternoon to our resource persons, and thank you for being here with us the whole day. Mr. Chair, I'd like to ask our former colleague, Secretary Roque, in the last Congress, has he ever participated as a resource person in the last Congress?
Not in the last Congress, po.
Okay. In this Congress, how many times have you been invited and how many times have you appeared?
Well, I was invited for the two times I was here. I was absent for the third and I was invited for today. So this is my fourth invitation.
You've appeared, Mr. Chair, how many times in those four invitations?
Three times, Your Honor.
And out of respect for our colleague, I've attended many hearings, Mr. Chair. In fact, just yesterday, we suspended the budget briefing because a secretary had said that he was sick. Secretary Roque is an intelligent person. He could have actually put in his letter he was sick. He could have put in there he had a hearing and not put Manila. My point of view is the other way, and we could have never checked. But I think he was good faith. He actually put where the hearing was, and I'm sure he knew that could have been checked. So I'm more inclined to believe that it was an honest mistake, considering that he's here, he's appeared multiple times. And I think the biggest issues are the substance of his various resolutions. It would be counterproductive, I think, to cite him in contempt, and whatever sanction that will be, my understanding is you would be holding him. But on the same token, I'm more inclined to maybe appeal to the movement, to Congressman Salo, instead of contempt, but some sort of a reprimand for that mistake, which he admitted, and admitted in public. I think that weighs quite a bit. And I'd really like to move forward to the substantive issues, and I think Secretary Roque will contribute more being here than citing in contempt, which I believe will be some sort of that's my question, Mr. Chair. If the resource person cited in contempt, what does that really mean? Wouldn't that be counterproductive? Because I'm assuming we're gonna continue the hearing today.
To respond to your query, Congressman Daza, it is pursuant to our rules on Section 11 of Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation, clearly states that there are several violations that a resource person may commit before this committee. And if these violations have been committed by any resource person, then a member can move for the committee to cite the resource person in contempt by a two-thirds vote consisting of a quorum. So in this case, as clearly stated by Congressman Ron Salo, the violation, as stated in paragraph E of Section 11, which is a contemptible act, Your Honor. So that is the basis, and that is the reason why perhaps the movement has moved to cite our resource person in contempt.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Chair. My question is, if the motion is carried, what would be the sanction for this situation?
Well, if the contempt is carried, what will happen is we will proceed to the next section, the Section 12. Pursuant to Section 12 of the same rules, the Section 12 titled penalties. So by a vote of two-thirds of the members present, there being a quorum, those cited under Section 11, paragraphs E and F shall be detained for a period not exceeding 10 days. That is what our rules say, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, for the clarification. which I think strengthens my view with the indulgence of my colleague, that that may be counterproductive when we have so many issues, national issues that we need to tackle, and this will just divert our focus for the more important issues. That's my opinion, Mr. Chair, and I hope my colleague will reconsider his motion, and maybe I could suggest, maybe should he find it in his heart to do that, it's maybe just a motion to reprimand for the honest mistake that Secretary Roque committed. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Daza. Congressman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to to add dun po sa sagot ng chairman natin, Chairman Barbers, for the information of Senior Deputy Minority Leader Paul Daza, under our rules, wala pong reprimand dun sa sa contempt, no? That's number one. Number two, if the good congressman is wary that Secretary Harry Roque cannot participate in the proceedings, he can. Because those resource persons cited in contempt can still participate in the hearing and in the succeeding hearings. So, kung ang agam-agam po ni SDML that we cannot extract some more information, vital information from former Secretary Roque, tuloy-tuloy po yung presence ni Secretary Roque even today until such time that this committee will suspend the hearing. Now, second, Mr. Chairman, with due respect to the position made by Co-Chair Abante, as the chairman has said, this committee should be fair to everyone. Well, in fact, kasi as I heard the statement coming from Co-Chair Abante that former Secretary Harry Roque has already publicly apologized. But the same is true with all others. Resource person that was cited in contempt during the past and even as of today in the case of Ms. Baterna. After she was cited in contempt, nag-appeal po siya and she apologized. But of course, she has violated our rules. So, yung contempt niya, she's serving now and is now present in today's hearing. So, ako, Mr. Chairman, again, with due respect to the position of Co-Chair Abante, I still stand that we should base on our rules, no, with regards to inquiry in AW legislation. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman, may I move for 1 minute recess?
We will decide is a motion to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt, which comes with it the penalty of a detention in the detention facility of the House of Representatives. Now, since there is already a motion by Congressman Ron Salo, it is now the opinion of the chair, which I hope my co-chairs would likewise follow, to vote on the motion.
Mr. Chair,
before
we do the voting,
okay, Congressman Fernandez,
we recognize and appreciate Attorney Harry Roque being apologetic, and as a matter of fact, Mr. Chairman, it took us so many hours or maybe minutes to discuss this motion that was moved by Congressman Salo, and we know for a fact that he is really so apologetic about the issue that what had happened. But unfortunately, I still remember the last time that we have discussed the issue of the SMNI, Celis and Badoy was cited in contempt. And Attorney Harry Roque was so vocal about attacking our institution and every members of this house. And I wanted to ask Secretary Roque before we render our vote on this issue, because as an institution, Attorney Roque, you malign each and every member of this house by telling that we are all corrupt and we are conniving with the DPWH. And a while ago, we were discussing about it. And we are very hurtful of what have you have said in that video that we have seen. As much as we wanted to accept your apology, somehow behind our minds and our hearts, there is this something that lingers in our in all of us, that you are being apologetic in this committee, but somehow when you are outside of this committee, words, bad words are being thrown against all of us. So, Attorney Harry Roque, can you somehow tell us why it is so that if you are here, you are being so nice with us, but if you are outside, it's the other way around? Can we have some comment, Attorney Harry Roque?
Please. Your Honor, aside from the fact that I respect the institution where I came from, that is also proper decorum. So I have always maintained that as a lawyer, I should be in top behavior while in Congress, and that is why there's a substantial difference when one is in the exercise of freedom of speech outside and when one is before an institution like Congress. No? Well, thank you very much for contemplating, Your Honors, whether or not this committee will cite me in contempt. I will, of course, accept it because I have no choice. But, Your Honor, I would like us to emphasize that the committee must abide with its own rules. No? And for now, I would like to make a query to the four committee secretaries of the Quad if we, in fact, have a quorum as we take this vote. Because I think as a person who may or may not be detained, I need to ensure at least that the rules are followed, that there be a two-thirds vote of the body, there being a quorum. And I do not know what quorum is involved, given that there is a Quad committee now, and which is actually a first as far as legislative history is concerned, no? That there are four committees. I'm just doing so, Your Honor, because I leave my fate to you, but the that faith should, of course, be in conformity with the rules. But thank you very much, Your Honors.
Yeah, Mr. Chair, my question, Mr. Chair. Mr. Secretary, is that are you being truthful with all your accusations against the institution and against all the congressmen when you deliver those statements after the contempt that was issued by all of us with Celis and Badoy?
Your Honor, I still represent Celis and Badoy. And I raised legal grounds against the contempt. I said that there was no due process because in jurisprudence, there must be a show cause order before being cited in contempt. And I also said that the exercise of freedom of expression should not be deemed to be contemptible, especially under the facts of the Celis-Badoy case, because they were raising an issue of public interest. So I do not know what other matters the good chair is referring to, but I certainly know how the institution works. I respect the institution, but we all know that there are also abuses within the institution, no? Which should not in any way affect the integrity itself of the institution, but certain practices will have to be condemned if, in fact, one sees them happening.
Yeah, we understand your kind of representing the SMNI, and we understand as well that of your freedom of expression. But of course, you have established also friends among the members of this house, and with that collective accusations against all of us, that really hurt a lot of members of this 19th Congress. And that's the reason maybe we have a long discussion about your predicament because of that friendship that you have established in this Congress. But of course, we have to follow our rules, as what you have said a while ago, that there are certain rules that we have to follow. Painful as it may be, but you have a lot of friends in here, but we have to do our job. We hope you will understand that, Secretary Roque.
Yes, Mr. Chair. I'm always guided by the fact that I'm probably one of the most heavily criticized personalities in this country. You know? And I have to take these criticisms in stride because of the importance of freedom of expression. And I would hope that all public servants would take to heart the decision of this honorable court, of the honorable court, that public servants should not be onion skinned. But in any case, as part of my rights as a person who may or may not be cited in contempt, may I know, Mr. Chairs, if we have a quorum at least to determine if I should be cited in contempt. And this is a first, because this is a first meeting involving four committees, so I do not know how the quorum will be determined. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Maybe, Mr. Chairman, after this, we will be establishing if we have a quorum or
that's correct.
None.
Mr. Chair.
But for the meantime, thank you, Mr. Attorney Harry Roque, for that reply.
Mr.
And I yield back to the chairman.
Mr. Okay. Chair, may I say something for a while before anything
Before I acknowledge Congressman Abante, let me just reply to the query of Attorney Harry Roque with respect to the quorum.
Mr. Chair, he has no right. He has no right whatsoever to speak of the quorum, Mr. Chair. I'm saying is, his right is to appeal. He has no right whatsoever to ask for a quorum. Mr. Chair.
I absolutely agree with you, Congressman Abante, but in response to the query of Attorney Harry Roque, kung ano yung quorum sa Quadcom, para lang malinaw, babasahin ko ang ground rules that we all approved and adopted during the organizational meeting of the Quadcom. Quorum, the presence of a quorum in each of the committees concerned is necessary to conduct meetings of the joint committee. 1/5 of all the members of the committees concerned shall constitute a quorum. In the event that a member in one of committee is also a member of another committee or committees, the attendance of such member shall be counted in each committee to determine the presence of the quorum. So that is the reply of the chair to the query of Attorney Harry Roque. Now, Congressman Abante, please continue.
Okay. Attorney Roque, I'd like to remind you that I was the one that moved to contempt Ms. Badoy, after which, as said by Congressman Fernandez, you have maligned this institution. Now, I still maintain my position to hold in abeyance this contempt charges against you. But I cannot do anything, Attorney Roque, if this whole body right now will cite you in contempt. That's the only thing that I'd like to say.
Thank you, Congressman Abante. Now we vote on the motion by Congressman Salo. May I ask Congressman Salo to please reiterate the motion?
Sir Chair, allow me to reiterate my earlier motion. But considering that former Secretary Attorney Harry Roque has lied to this committee, that amounts to disrespect on the members of this committee, which is contemptible under Section 11E of the Rules of this House of Representatives on inquiries in AW legislation. I therefore move, Mr. Chair, that he would be cited for contempt by this committee. Thank you.
There is a motion to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt for violating Section 11, Paragraph E of the Rules of Procedure Governing Inquiries in Aid of Legislation of the House of Representatives. There is a quorum in each of the committees composing the Quadcom. So, may I ask the committee secretary to please record the vote of all the members in this committee hearing.
Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, just a clarificatory questions, Mr. Chair, before we proceed on the voting. Mr. Chair, I was listening to the manifestation of Chairman Acop, and well, I agree with him. Voting should be done if there is a outright objection to a motion raised. I believe the motion that was raised by Congressman Salo, Ron Salo, has not been objected to, Mr. Chair. Did you object?
Can we get a clarification as to the position of Congressman Paul Daza with respect to the motion of Congressman Salo? Are you objecting, Your Honor?
Well, I beg to disagree with my good friend, Chairman Acop. The chair had opened the floor for comments before taking it to a vote. So my position is the chair had already decided to let people speak and then take it to a vote. But I will abide by your ruling, Chair. Should you take that position, but if you want to take it to a vote, I'm also willing to vote.
So in that case, if I may be allowed to explain, in that case, Mr. Chair, if the good gentleman from the good deputy minority leader accede to the fact that even the chair can decide, the chairman can decide whether to cite Attorney Roque in contempt or not, then we will just simply yield to the decision of the chairman and no longer proceed with any voting, Mr. Chair, because under the rules, the only way we can proceed with the vote, Mr. Chair, if there's an objection, and since there's no objection, we relay. I mean, I agree with Congressman.
The rules states that 2/3 of the member present must agree to a motion in order that the motion will be approved and carried.
Yes.
So in this case, the motion to cite Attorney Harry in contempt was properly made by the move-on, and no objection was put forward, meaning it is a unanimous decision in accordance and in approval of the motion of Congressman Salo. So the motion is to cite him in contempt. So since, again, there was no objection made by any of the member present, therefore, the ruling of the chair and the members is that Attorney Harry Roque is now cited in contempt. Okay? So, again...
Mr. Chair.
Mr.
Chair, just a quick manifestation. I will not be questioning your ruling. I'd just like to register my vote as a no for that motion.
So isn't that an objection?
Mr. Chair?
Okay, it's a vote. Now, I just wanted
to just for the record, I didn't want to delay it any further. Okay. I could have objected and make everybody vote.
Thank you.
But I wanted to give you that flexibility to immediately rule on it as requested and by Chairman Acop and Kong Ajong.
Thank you.
But just for the record, I would have said I voted no for that motion.
Thank you, Congressman Paul Daza. The motion of Congressman Ron Salo to cite Attorney Harry Roque in contempt is now approved.
Mr. Chair, can I move for reconsideration?
Mr. Chairman.
Let us first hear the member. The rule clearly states that after citing in contempt a resource person, a proper motion of the penalty must be open to the body. So is there any motion?
Mr. Chair, can I move for a few minutes suspension?
Okay, Harry Roque was cited in contempt for violating Section 11, Paragraph E of our rules. And after the contempt, the next, the proper motion is to follow Section 12, which speaks of the penalty. Is there any motion? Congressman Salo?
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, and to this honorable committee, in consideration of the fact that the resource person, former Secretary Harry Roque, is my former law professor, fellow Kabayan Party List representative, and a former member of this House of Representatives, and in consideration also of his claim for honest mistake, and of course, the apologies that he has given to this committee, and finally, in consideration personal relations, as he has mentioned a while ago that he was my ninong, respectfully move, Mr. Chair, that the penalty be given be shortened to the barest minimum, which is just one day or 24 hours, Mr. Chair.
Second motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion, duly seconded, to impose a penalty of 24 hours to our resource person, Attorney Harry Roque. Hearing no objection, the motion is carried.